mental health and makeup. So we're going to be talking about anxiety, just what it is, how you can spot it, and like how you can deal with it when you feel like you those emotions are coming up. So I'm just going to be doing my makeup. As a makeup yam, by the way, is a mix of drugstore and the makeup Asemahle. So that's why I won't be like showing you, but this is what I'm using. But if you do want me to show you what I'm using, just comment down below and I'll just do it in the next video, because Asemahle, you can't guarantee, but if I show you something here, like a palette maybe, that you're gonna find it when you go look for it, you know what I mean? So yeah, let's just get into the video. Anyways, I set my brows with a styling gel. This one, Glow Sheen. I found this at ShopRite. So yeah, that's what I did. I just set it, like I brushed it up with a brush and that styling gel, and then I just let it dry so that it can. It's the same thing I use for my baby hairs, but right now I don't have any baby hairs. I didn't lay them. I'm gonna lay them after the video, but that's beside the point. So let's get into it. Anxiety. So anxiety is a feeling of uneasiness, dread, or fear about some undefined threat. But in most, like, in, but that undefined threat, it's not that, Ivana, it's undefined. Like, you kind of know what you are anxious about, but not really, you know? It's not immediate, but we'll get into that. So anxiety is that. It's a feeling of uneasiness, dread, or fear. When a person feels anxiety, they feel it because it's causing a threat to the bodily or physical harm, or it's just psychological. And when it's psychological, often it's a threat to the person's self-esteem and well-being. The feeling of anxiety is often like spread out and diffuse, which means it's like it's not just one part of you that's feeling the anxiety, it's the whole body. It's like you can feel about something, you know, very much something. So that feeling that you don't really know what's wrong, but you know there's something wrong, that is the feeling that makes it anxiety, you know? That's what anxiety is. The feeling that you don't know what's causing this feeling, but like, you know, it's, something is up, you know something is up. So that's how we can define anxiety. I don't know if Ndiyavakalana, but okay. Yeah. The characteristics of anxiety include apprehension, which is la fear that we were talking about, worry, increased tension, fear of the unspecified consequences, distress or fearfulness. So yeah, I don't know, like there's no need for me to explain most all of this because it's pretty upfront. And the last one is restlessness. I can definitely relate to this because when I'm anxious, I'm like, I can't sit still. I must be doing something, you know? So I can definitely relate with that. And that worry one, because you're worried. What are you worried about? You don't even know what you're worried about, but you are worried. You know, ne? But you don't really know. That's like, you know, but you don't know. That's what, yeah. And so, okay, now we're going to be moving on to E levels of anxiety. We're going to be differentiating them by mild, moderate, severe, and panic mode. So mild, the person experiencing the anxiety, their sensory input is heightened and their alertness is also increased. And with mild anxiety, it helps the person. Like, for example, when you have mild anxiety, as we said, your sensory input is heightened and your alertness is increased. An example of this would be, you know, when you have to write an exam, then you have not been preparing enough, so you are like, you're just gonna, this allows you to complete the task that you need to do. For most people, I think that's the kind of anxiety most people experience. When it comes to moderate, the ability to see anxiety yako is reduced, and then attention occurs. Moderate anxiety is that but they can still follow instructions as to, like, if you are helping them to calm down, and, you know, if you're trying to tell them to calm down or like move or whatever, they can still do that and they can follow whatever instructions, which makes it easier for the anxiety to be dealt with. So I just cut my crease off camera because I can't talk and cut my crease at the same time. Otherwise, you guys know how to cut your crease at this point, because this is not even a tutorial video. I'm just doing my makeup and talking. So we're moving on to the severe part of the anxiety. At this point, I'm talking but I'm not doing anything. The senses are more heightened than moderate, which means that the person focuses more on the short term now. This is like before you get to panic mode. Just you focus on the short term, now it must happen now, or if it doesn't happen now, like, then this thing or this undefined threat that you were worried about, it's gonna happen. So that's where the person is when they say a person has moderate anxiety. It means that they want the thing to happen now so that they can stop worrying about it and move on to the next thing, and so on and so on and so on. When a person is having moderate anxiety, their ability to focus on other things is diminished, they can't focus on other things. They need to focus on this thing and that's that, you know. So now moving on to panic mode. Panic, which is the last stage of anxiety. Here the thoughts of the person are irrational. They are rushing. Like, the person can't focus on one thing. They need to, like, they're thinking about this and then this and then this at the same time. And even these thoughts that they're thinking, they are random. It's not like the thoughts unrelated. It can be talking about this palette, and then I'm talking about school, and then I'm talking about what's happening on the highway or whatever. But all these thoughts, they're random, they are rushing, and then they are unfocused and irrational. And when a person is at this level of anxiety, they really cannot function for a long time at this point, because how do you expect to function like that? Because no. And that's why people, everything in their body, all the senses are heightened, all the thoughts are rushing, they're irrational, they're unfocused. So the person panics, like, what the fuck is happening to me? And then they panic. They either have the shortness of breath, they may faint, they may, you know, those kinds of things. Some of the feelings that the person is experiencing have different themes. So the themes include acceptance. So in acceptance, the person believes that they must always please other people, and that any kind of criticism means they're being rejected by the person that's criticizing them. The second theme is responsibility. The person may feel like what other people think or feel when they are around them is their responsibility, and if ever something goes wrong, then it's like definitely their fault, which it may not be. And the third theme for a person with anxiety is competence. They feel that they must always be perfect, and like they may say things like, strong people don't ask for help, or they may have those kind of thoughts, where they are thinking those things, but no, strong people don't ask for help, and they must never make a mistake, they must just be perfect, which it's not realistic to feel those things where you must always be perfect and you can never make a mistake, because how sway? We're all human. And whenever you try to explain this to a person living with anxiety, they find it hard to believe, because why mustn't I be perfect? Why must we make mistakes? Like, everything with them is their fault. Theme number four is control. They feel like they must always be in control, similar to the third theme, which was competence. They feel like they must never make a mistake, they must always be in control. And mostly when you make a mistake, that means maybe you have lost control. And they may also say things like, if I let someone too close to me, they may control me, they're gonna control me, or other people are trying to control me. If you're trying to give them advice, they're gonna be like, you know, you're trying to control me, no, and they often reject that treatment from you or that advice, because to them it feels like, no, you're trying to control me, and this is what I want to do, and I don't care about whatever else, because that's how they feel. The last theme of anxiety is the symptoms of anxiety. the symptoms of anxiety. In the symptoms of anxiety, the person feels like they know maybe that they have anxiety, so they tell themselves that I must be calm at all times. Now they're overdoing it because no one can be calm all the time. So that's what they're telling themselves, that I must be calm at all times. And when they are in panic mode, they think they are having a heart attack. So they are just essentially they're over exaggerating their symptoms. So yeah, they are over exaggerating their symptoms, because why must you be calm all the time? And you're not having a heart attack, babes. You're just having anxiety. You're just having a panic attack. A panic attack to them is like having a heart attack. So, or when they feel these symptoms of anxiety, they may think that, I'm going mad, or I'm dying, which is when they're having the panic attack. They may think, I'm going mad, I'm dying, and you know, just bad, just the worst possible scenarios. That's a person with anxiety, thinking about the worst possible scenario. How do we intervene on anxiety? We intervene with therapy, more specifically cognitive behavioral therapy. And cognitive behavioral therapy is based on the idea that a person's feelings and behaviors in any given situation are based on his or her interpretation of what they assume about the experience that they are having. So, for example, if a person experiences anxiety after a breakup, it's not that the breakup itself is causing the depression, but what their thoughts and what their beliefs are about a breakup is actually causing the anxiety. And if do we see each other? So how cognitive behavioral therapy works is there is a ABC method, ne? UA is the activating agent, which is the breakup, and UB is the belief system. A person may believe that a breakup is like a sign of failure and, you know, like giving up. So that would then lead to OC, which are the consequences, which are the emotions and or behavior. So A, activating agent, is the breakup, and then B is the belief system. Belief system is that breakups happen because you failed in the relationship, or you know, those kind of thoughts. And then OC is the consequences, which is Puma, and that means it's kind of like it's the emotions and the behavior, which is the anxiety. The specific interventions to help ourselves, we're having a bit of anxiety, is mental exercises. So we can do mental exercises such as counting down from 50, so counting backwards from 50, doing puzzles, and playing general knowledge games like 60 seconds or charades, come on, those kinds of games, just to distract yourself from the thought of whatever it is that's worrying you or causing you to be apprehensive, you know, the symptoms that we talked about earlier. The lighting keeps changing. I don't know. Yeah, I think as Ilanga keeps going in and out, so that's why. I don't know. Some other activities that you can do to distract yourself when you have anxiety is absorbing activities, which means activities that are going to reduce your physical tension. So you can, these activities include going swimming, going for brisk walks, walk fast, and doing yoga if you're into that. But I would suggest that, yes, do yoga. Yoga is cheaper because you don't have swimming pools, and it can get boring just leaving your house sometimes. So yoga, you can do yoga by yourself and just download apps, and here you are. Blush and go. The second last thing you can do is focusing on an object. So whenever you feel like your anxiety is coming on, you focus your attention on a neutral object, such as a piece of furniture, maybe around the house. Maybe you can focus on a chair, the TV, and then while you're focusing on that chair or that TV, you can describe it in as much detail as possible, just so you can distract yourself from your anxiety. Because mostly, if you're focused on something, you describe the chair, whatever. The chair is brown, it's wooden, it has leather, and whatever. And while you're doing that, you're not thinking about whatever was causing you anxiety. You just focused on the chair, and you're describing it in as much detail as possible. Keep on finding things until you feel like, okay, I have come down now, and I can, you know, I can continue with whatever I was doing. So that's what focusing on an object means. And by the way, I did say most, well, all these techniques are, or all these interventions are cognitive distraction therapy, or techniques, you know. I thought I wasn't recording. The last cognitive distraction technique is sensory awareness. And then, so sensory awareness, you focus all your attention on your surroundings, and you use all of your senses. So for example, I'm sitting here, and okay, what can I see? First sense, I see, okay, there's a bed, there's a table, there's whatever. And then the second sense, okay, what is that smell? I smell makeup, because currently I'm putting on makeup, and that's what I've been doing. So that's the only smell I can smell. And then the third sense, what can I hear? What do you hear? I hear cars passing, I hear people talking, and nothing else. Ne? I hear myself talking. And then the fourth sense, what can I feel on my hands? I feel this thing. It feels, how does it feel? It feels soft, it feels smooth. And then, what's the other sense? There's five senses. I smell. Oh. And then sense number five. Okay, what can I taste? Nothing, because I have not eaten the whole day, so my taste just tastes like a mouth. It doesn't taste like anything, you know? So that's what sensory awareness is. It's just focusing your attention on your surroundings and just taking the surroundings in through your senses. What do you see? What can you feel? What can you taste? What can you smell? What can you hear? All those things. Okay, let me put this eyeliner on. Okay, guys, this is the final look. How do you like it? Me too. I like it too. If you like it, then don't forget to like this video and comment down below any thoughts you had about today's topic and any questions that you might have. I will make sure to answer them as soon as I can. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe, and thank you. Bye.